In this video, we will try to understand what is jQuery, and we will also see a simple example of jQuery. jQuery is a reusable JavaScript library which simplifies your JavaScript code. Remember, jQuery is not meant to replace JavaScript. jQuery has derived from JavaScript. So jQuery is a library while JavaScript is a language. So jQuery sits on the top of JavaScript and makes your development easy, makes your JavaScript code easy. So let's go ahead and do a simple demonstration of how does jQuery simplify our JavaScript code. So you can see here, I have a very simple HTML text box here. And let's say that we want to go and set this text box to hello jQuery, right? So if we have to do that by JavaScript, right? So how we do that, we'll first go ahead and put the script tag here, right? And in JavaScript, you know, if you want to refer a HTML element, you have to use the DOM, that is a document object model, right? So we have to say here document.getElementById. So it is txt1, and then I will say here dot value and hello jQuery, right? So you can see the syntax here of JavaScript is so lengthy, long and cryptic, isn't it? So if I go and run this, nothing will happen. It will just go and display me hello jQuery. You can see that, right? Now let's go ahead and see that how this whole syntax becomes short if we use jQuery. So as we have already said that jQuery is nothing but it's a reusable library. So the first thing is we need to go and download this library and add that library reference into our project, right? So let us go to the site here. So the site from where you can go and get the jQuery files is jquery.com/download. Okay, so if you go to this site here, right, you can see that there are lots of versions of jQuery files here, like jQuery 1.2x, and then you have jQuery 2.x. So it looks to me that jQuery 2.x is the new version. So if you're seeing this video, let's say after 5 years, right, probably there can be jQuery 5.x, right? So currently this is the latest version. So let's go ahead and download this file. So I'm going to go and save this file into my project folder here. So you can see that that's my project web application 4. So I'm going to go and save this here. And I'm going to go and add that jQuery file into my project here. So I'm going to say here add existing item, right? And I will go and add this jQuery 2.1.1.min.js. Okay, in the next video we'll try to understand what is this min.js. okay, if you go and open this jQuery file here, right, you will see that there are some JavaScript code here. So this is what exactly the jQuery project is all about, right? It's a reusable library. Okay, so let's not go into what exactly is written in this file, right? But let's try to see that how it goes and simplifies our syntax over here, right? Now once you have included the jQuery file inside your project, the next thing is you have to refer the jQuery file into the ASPX page or onto the ASPX page. So I'm going to go and drag and drop this jQuery file onto my page here. So you can see now the jQuery file has been included on the page. jQuery syntaxes are written in a SSS format. Okay, so what is this SSS format? So S, first thing, you know, all the jQuery syntax starts with a dollar sign. So the first thing, you know, is that you have to start with a dollar sign. The second is you have to go and select the element. So for example, currently our element is txt1, right? So in order to select this element, we have to say your hash txt1, okay? And the last one is you have to go and shoot your method or shoot the command. So at this moment, I want to go and set the value to hello jQuery, right? So when you're writing the jQuery command, the first thing is you need to start with a dollar sign. So that is the first S. The second S is you have to go and select the element. So for example, in this case, our element is textbox txt1. And the last thing is you have to go and shoot your command. So that is currently we are setting the value of the textbox. So you can now see that how this jQuery syntax has simplified your JavaScript code. You look at the top JavaScript code, document.getElementId, E capital, B capital, I capital, and then dot value and etc. Right? And look at over here. Start with a dollar sign, select the element, and fire your command, right? So I'm going to go and comment this part here. So if I run this, the output is absolutely same. hello jQuery, but you know this hello jQuery is displayed by using the jQuery syntax here. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we did the following. We first defined jQuery. We tried to understand, you know, what is the difference between jQuery and JavaScript. We saw that from where we can go and download the jQuery files. And then we also saw a simple hello example of jQuery. Thank you so much.